Well, Marcus takes me to some lovely places, and yet again, we're on a EICR, and we're carrying on this little miniature series of them. And you found an interesting immersion heater under here, haven't
we? Yeah, we have. So we've got a dual element immersion heater, one at the bottom, one at the top. Okay. Maybe designed for an economy 7 tariff, where you have the dual one, but not necessarily. They've both got their own supply, okay? So when we look here, though, at this cap.
Yeah, nice bit of blue tape. Yeah.
There's a nice bit of blue tape, which actually there's no top to the lid as such. It's been broken off, so it's fully exposed.
Okay. Someone's had a go at repairing that, though, so we know someone's been in here. Can you lift it slightly up forward? Yeah, it's obviously not on.
No.
Okay, so if I was to come in here, maybe loose hands and all the rest of it. Now, this is where we want people's comments, isn't it? Because lots of people might go, oh, I can see that. It's definitely the blue neutral there on its stud as it goes in. But what's happening to the line conductor?
Yeah, so again, this is where sort of... You know, it's controversial because lots of people may code this in a different way. People might code it a C1, people might code it a C2. Now, what we're looking at here is actually, can we physically immediately touch something that is gonna cause an electric shock or electrocution? And the answer is gonna be very tough to, because the way terminals are designed are actually, they're greater than IP2X. So we can't physically touch any live part with our finger. So really interested to see what people say in terms of C1, C2, C3, maybe an FI, find out who broke it. Sort of looking at what people would maybe code this in terms of, obviously we've pulled that up now, it was taped down, so we have to take that into consideration as well.
So within that condition then, Marcus, I take it we're going to leave it turned off and obviously indicate to the owner of the property what we're going to do. Is it a replacement?
Yeah, so it's not necessarily a replacement element as such. I've ordered a replacement lid online, if you like, and we're going to leave it turned off for the time being and isolated, because it's not detrimental to the business use as such anyway. Not that that would come into consideration if it was a C1. We have to sort it while we're here, either repair it or isolate the power to it. We're going to isolate the power to it just to be safe on the safe side, knowing that I'm here for the next couple of days and it will be repaired. So,
and if you're interested in any more EICR videos, we've got to check out the video on screen now.